Hello, I am going to talk you through how to solve the Jackson fish tank problem. The base of Jackson's fish tank has a surface area of 64 square centimeters and is filled to a depth of 6 centimeters. If the height of Jackson's fish tank is 10 centimeters, how much more water will be needed to fill Jackson's fish tank to the brim? So this is a lot of words, but basically what it's telling us is that the bottom right here has a surface area of 64 square centimeters. So we know the length times the width is 64 square centimeters, and it's filled to a depth of 6 centimeters. So the height is 6 centimeters. So if we wanted to solve the volume of that, we just do 64 square centimeters times 6 square centimeters. But that's not what the problem's asking. The problem is asking, if the height of Jackson's fish tank is 10 centimeters, how much more water will be needed to fill Jackson's fish tank to the brim? So their first step is going to be to find the difference between the total height of the fish tank and the depth, or how high the fish tank has been filled with water. So we are going to subtract 6 centimeters from 10 centimeters because it's filled 6 centimeters, but it's 10 centimeters in total. So 10 minus 6 equals 4. So the space, or the height of the fish tank that is not filled with water, is 4 centimeters. So we are going to multiply that height, 4 centimeters, the space that's not filled, by 64 square centimeters, which is the surface area right here. So the surface area right here is going to be the surface area, same surface area as right here, it's the same. So the answer is 64 square centimeters times 4 centimeters is 256 cubic centimeters. And how you're going to record that on your response sheet when you complete this assessment again is 256 cubic centimeters, 256 cubic cm, or 256 milliliters, because a cubic centimeter is the same thing as a milliliter. Okay, I hope this helped.